fils de bourgeois ou fils d'apôtre. Tous les enfants sont comme les
bourgeois. Who's in charge? It's like LA. Where is LA? There's no center. There's no place. So what the reason is, and it gets to Henry Kissinger's little quip, if I call up Europe, who answers the phone? The fact is, if you live in Europe for a while, you know the answer to that. Everyone answers the phone. It's a party line, and they all have their own agenda and then have to listen to each other. So in Europe, no one can dominate the game. It's a network. In other words, the Brits can't, the French, the Germans can't dominate the game, the regions can't, the end, civil society groups can't, and even the companies can't. So it's truly created a network out of just the sheer context of it, where each constituency, each group has to find a way to optimize the interests of the broader agenda in order to get their interest included. So it's terribly slow, very frustrating. It's completely distributed, and there's no fact that says the buck stops here. But as excruciating as it is, this network governance fits the sensibilities of a distributed world, where kids are growing up in open access and
mesh
network
work.
Models, and that's why we're pushing an energy model now based on hydrogen and distributed energy for Europe that would be commensurate with a network approach to politics. If you're having a politics that's going to be distributed, you need an energy regime that's not top-down and elite like coal, oil, gas, and uranium, but rather distributed like renewables and hydrogen and smart grids. So the bottom line here is that this is a new governing experiment. It's quite interesting. There are only two superpowers. There ain't five. There ain't ten. And China and India are nowhere near. China right now is like the sixth power in the world, right around where Italy and France is. The EU is a political unit. And I think Americans need to understand that, but I think on the second Bush administration, there was at least the beginning of this fleeting recognition when the president came and Condoleezza Rice came. I think a new administration in Washington in 2009, regardless of the Republican or Democrat, will start to get up to speed. There is two superpowers, two massive economic superpowers only in the world. Europe is not history. Europe is moving, and its growth is right now better than the U.S. this year.
Les vieux ne parlent plus, ou alors seulement parfois du bout des yeux. Même riches, ils sont pauvres, ils n'ont plus d'illusions et n'ont qu'un cœur pour deux.